We also use more conventional kinds of languages, for example, Esperanto. You know, it's the international second language. And for those of you who are unfamiliar with that language, we're not very good at it, but we do it. I can give you a taste of the language by going over some of the vocabulary. For example, hundo is dog. It's kind of like hound. Besto is animal. Sporto is sport. Birdo is bird. Cat would be kato. Ink is inko. Or if we switch to cities, London would be Londono. Club is clubo, elefanto is elephant. Surprise is surpriso. You get the idea. Now, that's rather straightforward, but in our use of language, we invented a code using Esperanto in which the correct meaning comes from the rhythm of our mispronunciations.
One of the things we do, which is kind of unusual maybe, is to indulge in certain kinds of abstract game playing in preparing for a new piece or a performance. And one of these games that we use, one of my favorites, is called square packing. Some of you have probably done square packing. The purpose of square packing is, in general terms, has to do with economy. The point of it is to take identical unit-sized squares and you pack those into a larger square. More specifically, the question is, what is the smallest size that the large square can be to fit a certain number of small squares into it? Let me show you a few examples. Now on the left there, down at the bottom, you see a couple of different packings of, those are five packs, they're called. The one on the left is the best known five pack, and the size of the large square is 2.707, as opposed to the one to its right, which is 2.828. And you see a 10 pack, the best 10 pack, and a couple of 11 packs. The best known 11 pack, which was figured out with a computer, is the one on the extreme right. I don't remember what the size of the square is. Just to give you an example of one of the kind of games we play.
I want to go on to the more complicated kinds of square packing. For example, if you use irregularly sized squares that have, let's say, instead of all being unit sized, they are 1, 2 squared, 3 squared, 4 squared. That's kind of system. The question then is, can a large square be cut into such a system of small irregular squares with no leftover space? Now, what we've done is, the longhand way of doing it is that you take 1 squared, 2 squared, and you add that together, you add that to 3 squared, add it to 4 squared, 5 squared. Eventually, you get to 24 squared, and at that point, if you've added those all up, you have 4,900, which is 70 squared. Now, for the first time, a question will arise in your mind. Is it possible to pack all 24 of those different size squares into the potentially 70 by 70 large square? The answer is no. But interestingly enough, you can pack 23. And it's also interesting that there are 24 versions of packing 23. And it's also interesting that the one square the one square that's missing is always the 7 by 7 square. And that's the one that's left out over here at the corner. The only leftover space are those rectangles you see that don't have any squigglies in it. That's square packing. Let me show you an example, another kind of combination where you combine, you take two pieces, let's say, and you take a portion of one piece and then you do the other portion of another piece, and you come back and you alternate that way. And it's amazing the degree to which you can you can have surprising results in the sense that you get a third piece which is really quite different. You want to do that one? Yeah.
Beautiful dreamer, welcome to me. I got rhythm, I got music, light and moonbeams, could ask for anything more.
That's it.